See everybody this morning. If everyone will, we'll stand and take up the offering this morning. It's good to see everybody this morning. We pray for the service. Pray the Lord just have his way here this morning. Pray for Brother Terry. See, come. Most of all, pray for the lost.
1054.
Terry, you pray for us.
Here I am, first of all, I ask for you, my sin, Lord, mark our lives every day. God, I thank you, Lord, for loving us, God. Thank you for sending your Son, God, to die from our death, Lord God, on the old rugged cross, Lord God, so that a sinner like me, Lord God, might have a way unto salvation, Lord God, to enter into your kingdom, Lord. And I pray to God that you just fit each and every one that's here this morning, Lord, if there's one here that's never accepted you as a personal Savior, God. I pray, Lord God, that you just convict their hearts, Lord, before they leave this morning, Lord. Let them know, Lord God, yeah, let them see, Lord, right. Without you, Lord God, there is no way to heaven, Lord God. The only way is a straight, narrow path unto a dying hell, Lord. I pray to God that you just be with this church, Lord, help to grow, help to prosper, Lord God. Now I pray to God that you just have all things in your will and your way, in our hearts and in our life, Lord God, in your holy, sweet, and precious name. Amen.
Amen.
254.
Some glad morning we shall see Jesus in the air, coming after you and me in joy is ours to share. Oh, rejoicing there will be when the sun shall rise, heading for the Jubilee yonder in the skies. Oh, what singing, oh, what shouting, on the happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, God, glory, hallelujah, when we meet our blessed Savior in the skies. Sing that now I almost see all the saints in dead, rising for the Jubilee that is just ahead. In the twinkling of an eye, change with them to be. All the living saints to fly to that Jubilee. Oh, what singing, oh, what shouting, on that happy morning when we all shall rise. Oh, what glory, hallelujah, when we meet our blessed Savior in the skies. When with all the heavenly hosts all shall rise, oh,
know, I'm not the fifth cousin John if I met. But I say something. You know, I prayed for this part right here. Let's coach come back up and see all these other kids come back up here. You don't know how much we miss you when you don't come. You know, it blesses my heart so much to see what's going on out here. I thank God for the opportunity to come to church if we can do this. If we can get up, if we want to speak to somebody, we need to be taught. Thank God for the many blessings given us every day. You know, well, I thank God that nobody here has got the virus. You know, maybe not had that. I hope you don't ever get the virus. I thank God for that. You know, without God's help, we can't do nothing. We can't do nothing. We need to pray, keep praying for each other, keep praying for the churches, keep praying for the people of God. We have family and loved ones. We need to keep praying for that. That God will take care of us. You know, today's first day, but this has been back since it started. It's such a blessing to walk in this morning. I don't know how much it meant to me. I know it means lots of them too, but you know, like I tell them, I said, I probably go on air, it's great. People can't come, it's great to watch. But it ain't like being here. And I thank God for the opportunity to do this.
Amen.
Good morning, good to see everybody this morning. It's good to be here, good to see everybody here this morning. Let's pray for the service. We get into the bulletin here. May 31st communion, also May 31st special on for building fund. Also June 14th special on for youth group. Also June 14th business meeting. June 20th youth trip to Carowinds. We'll do something with youth either way. I don't know about that yet.
Thanks, Sierra. And they've already decided we're just going to have a fun day here. We're going to set up all the water things.
We'll have a fun day here for the youth. And we'll make sure they have a good time. Okay, so do pray about that. June 28th, special on the building plan. July 9th through 12th, Ebenezer Bible Camp. We're still waiting to see about that. Hopefully, we'll still be able to do that. If not, Lord knows, we'll work it out. So, August 1st, back to school bash. We pray for that. We pray for that. It'll be school supplies, stuff like that. Anything else? Is that it? That's it. We'll get into the prayer request. David Sutherland, Unspoken. David Ward, Deb Jennings, Lisa Stout, Larry Stout, Alex Tressler, Stacy Keith, Becky Wilson, Gary Nolan Cross, Ebenezer Christian Home, Doug Cross, Jack Walton, Dennis Lewis, Youth Group, David Wilson, Murray Tolley, Harold Rice, Linda Highland, Dorothy Dixon, Clarence Braden, Christine Harrison, Ellen Lay, Ashley White, Juanita Purdue, Nancy and Charlie Green, Jeremy and Natasha Goods, Eddie Cross, Johnny Triplett, Billy Joe McFadden, Jason and Sierra, Curry Melissa, Aiden Family, Stephen Angie, Christopher Harris, Mike Carroll, Rosie Lewis, Asa Maines, Buck and Elaine, Aaron Steele, Stella Payne, New Building and Land, Dana Buchanan, Susan Hicks, Carter Harris, Andy Leonard, Clifton and Adam Worley, Kennedy Greer, Dorothy Madison, Bailey Cadoo, Carolyn Porter, Murray and Grace Haymore, Ross and Joyce, Edna Smith family, Terry's family, Andy Lowe, Todd Cross, John and Amy, Tyler Taylor, Rick Baltman, Earl Fritz, Dan Stout, Louise Markham, John Murray Bishop, Kevin Bernard, Reason family, Tara Forster, Donna Porter, Emily Church, Eggers family, Henry Cross, Charles Worley, Megan and Eli, Jeff Phipps, Darrell Adams, Melissa's family, Brandon Greenwell, Peggy Saunders, Stacy Waldrick, Joel Duggar, John and Christine Haymore, Mandy and Josh Paulson, and the Larry Stout family. Anybody else? Is that it?
Next Sunday, we will be having a dinner here at the church. It's because we want to.
Yeah. Start that, because we always want to.
They kept asking me what for. I said, because we want to.
The next Sunday after.
Yeah, so everybody fix a dish. Need somebody fix some ham. If somebody don't fix chicken, we'll have to cancel it.
We got to make up some reason to do it.
Oh, we want to. You call it a belated Easter.
Next week in Memorial Day, can't we do something? We do
Memorial. It's a Memorial Day.
Memorial Day, Tom's Curry wants to. All right. So next Sunday after service, we'll be eating out here because Curry wants to.
Everybody said they started eating groceries. Eat them. We'll eat out. We'll eat out.
Everybody's turning, eating groceries. So that'll be next Sunday. Bring some kind of dessert, whatever, and a dessert and drinks, right? Ain't that how we do it? Do pray for that. I guess because we want to. Any other, anybody else prayer request? Any birthdays coming up? Any anniversaries?
Rachel's birthday.
Was she 50? You always get told on, don't you? You can't get away with it. She's old, just give her time.
I ain't as old as she.
Everybody's real standing.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Any anniversaries? No anniversaries? Let the kids sing.
Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Today, we just ask you to mind the Spirit of the Lord. Whatever God bids you to do today, that's what we ask of you to do today. So maybe somebody here has got a word on your heart, testimony, or a song, something you'd like to say or do for the Lord today. Hearts and minds are clear, then we'll open our Bibles up to the book of St. Luke. St. Luke chapter number 2. When you find your place, you're able, please do stand with us for the reading of God's Word. Be much in prayer for services today that we'll just do what God would have us to do. And I don't have no idea why in the world John thinks he's got to have some kind of special reason to have a dinner. Amen. I'm just kidding him. I told him he was talking this morning about being in the middle and being a boss in the middle and being in the middle of boss. And I told him, I said, after service, I figured out what in the middle meant. It means he had chores to do, and Angie was telling him what to do, so he was in the middle of doing those. Amen. If you're married, you can say amen.
Amen.
Amen. We do appreciate you today. Luke chapter number 2, and we're going to begin to read it verse number 41. St. Luke chapter number 2, we're going to begin to read it verse number 41. The Bible says, and now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of the Passover. Now, if you don't know who we're talking about Jesus. Amen? We're talking about Jesus. And verse 42 says, and when he was 12 years old, they went up to Jerusalem after the custom of the feast. And when they had fulfilled the days as they returned, and the child and Jesus tarried behind in Jerusalem. And Joseph and his mother knew not of it. But they, supposing to have been him to be in the company, went a day's journey, and they sought him among the kinsfolk and acquaintance. And they found him not. And they turned back again to Jerusalem, seeking him. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you today, Lord, to summon ourselves before thee. Thank you for this privilege and opportunity, God, just to be able to come out into thy presence, into thy house. God, just to be able to worship in the fellowship with your people. Lord, I know today, dear God, that we've faced a lot of adversity over the years. We've faced a lot of adversity over the last few months. God, nothing more powerful, nothing more able than you are. I pray, dear Heavenly Father, you'll just give us a good service today, dear Lord. Just give us the message you have us to hear. Lord, the message you have us to say, and God will apply those words for our hearts and our daily living. God, if there's somebody here today that does not know the free pardon of sin, does not know you as Savior, I pray today, dear God, that receive you before it's everlasting too late. Lord, I pray a hedge of protection around your folks.
Lord, not only here at Heavenly Life Baptist Church, but every place today that congregates at this meeting and the congregations is gathered together. God, you'll protect them not only from this virus, Lord, but you'll protect them from the devil. Lord, the thoughts that he might have in their mind. Lead us, guide us, and direct us today, dear Lord, and we give you all the praise in Jesus' blessed name we pray. Amen. Amen. I was thinking a lot this week about some of the scriptures and the things that were said here, but I was thinking a lot this week, how many of you have ever dropped something or lost something down through a crack? Listen, I'm saying this way, every time we go up to Jason Sierra's house and Riley's out there playing, it's amazing to me. If Riley can find a screw, if he can find a nail, if he can find anything to pick up and he can find a crack to put it in, I promise you he's putting it in the crack and it's going to go through the crack. This week was trying to finish up all the plumbing and finish up all the water. I was trying to get ready to turn things on, and Jason said, you better don't forget that screw that Riley put down that little piece of pipe. And I'd forgotten about it. So I got down there and I cut it out, and sure enough, I said, you really think he got that little screw, that he got that screw down there, a sheetrock screw, down a half-inch piece of PEX pipe? Jason said, yeah, he put it down there. I said, we could hear it. I said, okay. So I got down there and I got it cut out, and there it was. There was the little thing. I got to thinking so many times in life that we've probably dropped things and things have fallen through the cracks, you know, and you have to work extra hard to get that thing out, or sometimes you might not have even gotten it back out. And with the way of the things that we're living in, and I got to thinking about this scripture here about Jesus, and when he's about 12 years old, Mary and Joseph, they got in kind of a routine, you know, that they went down to Jerusalem there. They went down for some of the customs and the things that they do yearly. And so easy, it's so easy to kind of get caught up in customs. It's kind of so easy to just get caught up in a routine, the things that you do, and you just do it over and over and over. It's kind of funny, some things already been mentioned about the message that Lord's already given me, but this morning, but I was thinking, Melissa and I was coming to church this morning, was talking about some other churches and hadn't been going to church, and talking about some churches we know of in the community and surrounding areas. They're still having parking lot services and having one service a week. And I'm not knocking that. And if you're out there listening, I'm not knocking what you're doing. I mean, just keep going for the Lord. Amen. If that's what God tells you to do, let's keep doing that. But to me, it's so easy to get caught up into a custom, and you get caught up in that routine, things begin to fall through the cracks, amen? You let some things slide, and you get used to going to church once a week, then you go to church once a week, amen? You get used to doing all these things, and you let some things slide. And I'll tell you what, it's easily done for things to fall through the cracks in our life. And you say, well, I just don't know if I'd let that happen or not. Well, listen, Mary and Joseph left their son back in Jerusalem, a 3 days journey, amen. I tell you what, if a man can leave Jesus, a man and woman, leave mom and dad, leave their son, much less leave Jesus back 3 days journey. Don't you ever think that we ourselves don't let things fall through the cracks. So this morning, I want you all to take a look in your life, and I want you to look through the cracks of your life and see what we can find. Amen. I tell you, one of the first places that we ought to start, even as a child of God, one of the first places we ought to look is to see if our prayer life has fallen through the cracks. Amen. I'll tell you right now, don't somebody amazes me. We want to talk about some crazy virus. Amen. Well, I'll tell you right now, look around, and one of the most important things in a Christian's life is a prayer life. Amen. Bible tells us in 1 Thessalonians chapter number 5 and verse number 16, he said to verse 17, he said, pray without ceasing. Amen. In other words, that means don't give up. I mean, don't just quit on prayer. I tell you what, keep on going with your prayer line. Don't pray one time and think it's done. I say continue in prayer and give the Lord to God. I tell you, so many times in years past, I've said this already, but it's worth saying again. So many times in years past, when tragedy happens in America, the word prayer and pray for our country comes out. Amen. I'll tell you what this virus has done. It's come across, and I haven't heard anybody talk about prayer. Amen. You want to know why? Because it's fell through the cracks. It's fell through the cracks in our Christian lives. It's an important weapon that God gave us. It's a direct line into heaven. Amen. I'm telling you what. It ain't like having to dial up and try to collect. It ain't like dialing up trying to find a line to get through on. He gave us a direct line into heaven, into the prayer room of God. Hey, we need to get over there, and we need to be ringing the bells of heaven. I ain't talking about some little old piddly eddy prayer. I'm not talking about some 10 or 15 second prayer. I'm talking about getting a hold of God.
Amen.
Amen. When's the last time we really got a hold of God? If we can't remember a time when we really got down, we sing a song about praying the whole night through. How long has it been? I tell you what, it shouldn't be very long. You shouldn't have to think too hard about the last time you got a hold of God. There's another song that says, there's been a few times. Hey, man, listen, there's been a few times that I reached up to heaven and got a hold of God. That's a shame, amen. That's a crying shame. You know why? You know why it's a shame when you saw a preacher and something? I'm going to tell you right now. God will give us access, amen. He'd give us a way to get a hold of him every minute of the day, every second of the day. But yet we take for granted. We let that fall through the cracks. I tell you what, if it's somebody in your family, if it's something you need, I promise you, you'll do what you can to get a hold of God. Well, I'll tell you, it's time right now that we got back to getting a hold of him on a regular basis.
Right.
Amen. Talking about praying.
Yeah.
Our prayer life. He gives us an example of prayer. We know the Lord's Prayer. That wasn't what you should pray every day. But that was how you should pray every day. Amen. Getting a hold of God, calling up on him. Amen. I'm talking about being serious in what we do. There are some conditions in prayer that we've let fall through the cracks. You know, we live such a busy life and all the things that we had to do and go on. You know, this old virus came in and it kind of forced us to slow things down, didn't it? I wonder if it slowed us down enough to realize what's important in our life. Amen. If we stop long enough to look and see. I'll tell you what. Prayer changes things. Amen. It'll change things all around. That's why prayer is so important. God give us a way to get a hold of him. It's better than sending up a back signal. Amen. It's better than having a direct line to the president. Hey, it's a line that we can get a hold of somebody who can make a difference. Who can take anything, any obstacle, any challenge, any trouble, any trial, any issue that we have, and nothing is too big for him.
Amen.
You know what? There's a lot of men and people in here at work in different jobs and different aspects of life. You may take a problem to them and they might be able to handle it. You might take a problem to them and it might stump them or confuse them. But I can tell you one thing, you'll never take anything to God that stumps him or confuses him. You'll never take anything to God in prayer that he's not able to do. Bible said, for with God, nothing's impossible. Amen. Now listen, there's some things he does not answer. He may not answer exactly the way I want him to answer a lot of times, but he knows what's best for me. Amen. If I let my prayer life fall through the cracks, all I'm doing is letting my life fall through the cracks. Amen. I'm talking about getting a hold of God. I think it's time that America got back to praying. I think it's time that Mountain City, Tennessee, and Butler, Johnson County, I think everybody listening out there, I think it's time we all got back to praying. I'm talking about reaching up. Just like old Paul and Silas over there in prison. You think they just cried out a little old routine prayer? I think they rung the prayer bells of heaven. Amen. And the stops fell off. I said, listen, get a hold of God and watch things change.
Yes.
Amen. Watch things change. Don't let it fall through the cracks. It's so easy to get so caught up in your little routine and you go to bed and we got this going on, got that going on. Yet we forget to do some of the most important things in our life. Get a hold of God. Talk to him. You know, I can speak as a parent and as a grandparent. There is nothing
that pleases us any more than for our children to call us or talk to us without being prompted or probed or forced to call us. Yeah. Amen. Call and just talk.
Right.
Call because it needs them. Just call. You know what? That's the same way it is with us when we go to the Lord in prayer. We are just calling on our Father. We're calling family. Amen. Somebody that we can count on. That's what God wants from us. He said, you have not because you ask not. Do you think God don't know what your needs are? Do you think He knows your needs before you even ask? He knows what all of us needs. He just wants us to get a hold of it. I say, don't let it fall through the cracks, but get a hold of it. We don't need to let fall through the cracks. We've been in, these people have been slowed down, been in quarantine, not been working, not doing all kinds of things. I was thinking this week, all this time we've had to do stuff. But we've had more time to do things in the past few months, in the past few weeks than we've ever had. And I wonder when the last time we picked up this book was. Amen. It's good to be saved.
Amen.
Whew, I was beginning to think y'all's half asleep. Look, this old book right here, the Bible tells us, Hebrews, he tells us, he said, to study to show thyself approved unto God. Amen. You don't have to prove me anything but to pick up this book. Hey, you want to know something? I don't want you to raise your hand. Some of you tonight, today, might be, y'all might read your kids' bedtime stories. You know the best bedtime story there is to read? Pick up this old book right here.
Amen.
I promise you, you'll find a good story to read them. Amen. Zacchaeus, about over there. Zacchaeus, we know Zacchaeus was a wee little man, wasn't he? Amen. Listen, they like to sing about him. How about reading to him about him? This old book right here will make a difference in your life as well. You want to know the problem? We're all searching for answers. We're all searching for things to help us to feel better. We're all searching for some direction. You wonder why in the world God's not speaking to you. You want to know why God's not speaking to you a lot of times? It's because you turned Him off. Amen. You ain't picked it up. I say, listen, our way to talk to God is through prayer. His way to talk to us is through this book right here. He opened this book up and you'll begin to hear God speak to you. He'll show you all kinds of things. He'll open up mysteries to you. Hey, if you'll just be willing to take and spend a little time with you.
Amen.
Don't let it fall through the cracks.
Right.
We can find time to do everything else. Amen. We can find all kinds of time. The old devil will do everything he can to lead us astray. I've told many people this lately. I tell you what. I hate to even turn the news on, don't you?
Yeah.
You don't know who to believe and what not to believe.
Amen.
You listen to the news more than 10 minutes, you'll hear 10 different stories. Amen. Amen. About the same thing. It's worse than trying to find out, go up to an accident and see 10 different people with 10 different witnesses. Amen. You'll get 10 different stories. That's what the little devil does. He's the author of what? Confusion. Amen. He likes to get confused. Don't know what to believe. All these things. Some of you come in here with all your conspiracy theories and all this stuff. All this stuff going on. Listen, I don't know what to believe, what not to believe when it comes to this world. But there's one thing I can guarantee you that has never been fake news. I can guarantee you it ain't never been false. It ain't never misled me or misdirected me. It ain't never given me bad advice. Amen. That's this old book right here. Now you pick up some old man's version of it, some old watered down version of it, you might get some mistruths. You might get misled. You pick up this old KJV right here, and I promise you, you'll find some answers in it. I tell you why. You say, well, why in the world do you believe that? I believe this. I believe it's the closest English word for word translation that a man has. I know that every word out of Hebrew and Greek did not translate. But when we bought my wife a book years ago, we bought her a song book, and in the back, we had a special order just to get a King James version of the verses. It was in some of it. In the back of that thing, it said the closest word for word translation to the English language. I'm going to tell you right now, if I'm going to stand and give an account of all the deeds done in this body, I want to know what I'm giving the account against. I want to know what I got to stand for. I want to know what I got to stand on. It's this old book. It'll make a difference in your life.
Amen.
Amen.
It'll make a difference in your life. This book right here is good for you. It's good for your soul. Don't let it fall through the cracks. We can find time to read all kinds of things. We can find time to do everything we want to. I wonder if we read that book half as much as we read Facebook. How much would we have? How much knowledge would we have? Amen. I wonder if we read that book as much as if we surf through that book as much as we surf through social media. Amen. If we'd be a little closer to God. Don't let it fall through the cracks, amen. Don't let this book fall through the cracks in your life. I tell you something else, don't let it fall through the cracks. It's our children, amen. It's these kids. We see these kids up here, and see these children up here singing and going on for God. And you know what? The old devil would love to have every one of them out there in the world doing something, amen. Doing something besides coming here. I'll tell you right now, I love to see those kids' face and the joy of they get by coming up here at Haven Light Baptist Church, because people love them up here, amen. People are trying to take care of them up here. I tell you what, I don't know if you get what Brother Danny said just a few weeks ago. They was talking to Isabella, and Isabella was getting dressed or getting ready or doing something, or was grumpy. He said she was grumpy. He asked her, said, "What's the matter, Isabella?" I said, "What are you going to do?" She said, "I want to go to church, amen." I can tell you, hey, that'll bless a preacher's heart, amen. That'll bless your heart. I tell you what, you better not forsake these kids. Let them go out there in the world. You better get them in the house of God. Because I'll tell you what, you leave them out there in the world and the world will take them.
Amen.
He'll take them. You give them an opportunity to go out there in the world will grab them. Amen. Amazes me. I heard a story a long time ago about an old fella that's up on the mountain. It's cold up on the mountain. It's down below freezing. And he come across an old snake. And that old snake was just curled up there in a little old ball. That old snake asked the searcher, "Would you just take me down the mountain?" He said, "I ain't touching you." He said, "You're just an old snake." He said, "Listen, I promise you." I said, I'm froze. I'm freezing to death. I'm going to die up here on this." He said, "I promise you, I won't bite you." He said, "I promise you, sir, I won't bite you. If you just take me down, get me down there on the bottom of the mountain somewhere, get me in the sun." Old guy picked him up, put him in his backpack, took him down the mountain. As you know, living in the mountains, it's easy to realize this. The further down the mountain you get, the warmer it gets. Amen. You can leave here and go somewhere else, down a little south, gets a little warmer. He got down there at the bottom of the mountain, and he reached in the pack, and take the snake out, grabbed the snake bit it. He said, "What are you doing?" He said, "You promised me you wouldn't be behind me." He said, "What do you think? I'm a snake. Listen, you turn your kids loose in the world. You give them an opportunity out there with Satan. What do you think he's going to do? He's going to bite them. He's going to take them." I say, don't forsake them. Don't let them fall through the cracks. Hey, but get them in the house of God.
Amen.
Keep them right here in the house of God. This is what's important, church. This is what's important. This is an important part. You say, "Listen, we're living in different times." We're living in different times.
Yeah.
We're living in strange times. We're living in strange times. We're living in the last days. We're living in the last days. Do you know what God said about His church? The gates of hell shall not prevail against
it.
Hey, man, they might come and arrest every one of us. They might come and arrest me today. I have no idea. But I promise you one thing, I'm not going to quit going for Jesus.
Amen.
Our Bible tells us, and listen, I want everybody to realize this and understand this. I know we're living in different times and things going on. If you don't want to come to church, don't come to church. If you want to stay at home, stay at home. If you're sick, stay at home. Amen. Don't make everybody else sick. But you've got an opportunity to come to the house of God, and God wants you to come, and you want to come, you've got a place to come.
Amen.
Come and worship God. Amen. Amen. Leave the world out there and come in here and worship God. Listen, I told you, if we're going to have us a little dinner out there next week, it ain't because we just want to have a little dinner. It's because we can get together. Amen. Because we can fellowship as God's people. We can eat together. We can eat spiritually. And we can eat physically. Why? Because this is what church is.
Amen.
Amen. About God's people.
Yeah.
We shouldn't let it fall through the cracks. We let church fall through the cracks. And you'll have what you got going on in a lot of parts of the world today. You'll have what's going on in a lot of parts of the country today. Well, they can't have church. Can't have but 10 people. I ain't got but 10 people. Somebody else brought 10 people. Nobody over here brought 10 people. I brought my 10. They come looking for us. You claim your 10, I'll claim mine. Hey, man. Church is important. It's important in a person's life. I remember as a young boy, I wasn't ever to the church. Very seldom was I ever to the church. I was sent to church some, but very seldom was I ever took the church. When I look back in my childhood, growing up all over the eastern part of the United States, here, there, and yonder, never went to one school more than 2 years of my life. Some of the best times I ever had was in church. As a kid, I didn't even know it. Didn't even know it. Didn't even know it until I got a little older. Hey, listen, don't forsake church, because it'll be a vital part of not only your life, but it'll be a vital part of your children's life. It'll be a vital part of the future of this country. It'll be a vital part of the humanity for this world. Don't let your family fall through the cracks. Hey, man, don't let family fall through the cracks. I know the story. We know the story of Lazarus, Martha, and Mary. I remember when Jesus first went into Martha and Mary's house. The Bible said that Mary came and fell at the foot of Jesus. Worship there. Mary was cumbered about with much work. She's busy cooking, cleaning, all those things, and getting the stuff ready. Martha got mad. You know what Jesus told her? She knew what Mary knew what was important. Mary knew what was important. Hey, man. She knew that Jesus wasn't always going to be there. She knew there was going to come a time when he wasn't going to be there no more. So she was a falling at the foot in worship. I tell you, we need to realize that we got family. We don't need to let them get too busy. We don't need to let them fall through the cracks. We need to think about our brothers and our sisters, our moms and our dads, our grandmas and grandparents, cousins and everybody else. We've got them all over the country. I hope some of them's listening today. If you are, give it all to God. I say, we don't want none of you to be out there in the world. And we want you to know that we love you. And we want you to come to Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. I'm already up. Something else we don't need to let sight of. We don't need to lose sight and let fall through the cracks our availability to God. You know God loves you. You know God loves you.
Amen.
You know how I know God loves you? Because he says so.
Right.
Hey, man, God don't just say, we may say I love you just because we want to say I love you. Just because we think it pleases somebody. You know God said he loved us because he loves us.
Right.
He loves you. You know why I say that? Listen. Here we are in Mount City, Tennessee, in the middle of a pandemic, and God saw fit to bring you to church today.
Yeah.
He knows all about your past.
Yeah.
He knows all about the things you've done. He knows all the places you've been, the things you've said, all the bad stuff in your life.
Right, amen.
And he still loves you.
Yes, Lord.
He still loves you. He just wants you to be available. He wants you to be available. I'm going to move on. I ain't going to spend no time. I want to spend right here. This is where I'm going to close. Don't let your life fall through the cracks. Your life is important. Your soul is important. I want you to know you may think, you may feel that you're not important to anybody. You may feel like you've been forsaken and run down by everybody in the world. There's been circumstances that's upended you. There's things going on around us. The world's falling apart. But God still loves you.
Amen.
He saw fit to get you at Heavenly Light Baptist Church here today and give you an opportunity to keep you from falling through the cracks. He's sealing them up, giving you an opportunity to get into the family, to get things made right, to come back where you should be. God wants you to do that today. Is every head's bowed, every eye closed, every Christian praying, every heart searching? I don't know who you are. I don't know where you're at. I don't know what's been going through your life. But I can tell you this much. God loves you. He loves you, loves you, loves you. If you're here today and maybe you've never been saved, would you be honest with yourself and honest with God? We're not here to call you out or pull you out or anything like that. We just want to pray for you. Would you just stick your hand up and right back down and say, "Preacher, pray for me. I'm lost. I'm lost." Maybe you're here today and you say, "Preacher, I'm not really sure if I'm saved or not. I don't know really where I stand with God. Would you pray for me?" Just stick your hand up and it right back down and say, "Pray for me. Pray for me." Maybe you're here and you say, "Preacher, I know I'm saved, but I'm not where I should be with God." Would you just stick your hand up and put it right back down and say, "Pray for me." Amen. 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 Maybe you're here today and you say, "Preacher, I just need to give my life back to God. I just want God to take me and make me what He had me be." Would you stick your hand up and put it right back down and say, "Pray for me. Pray for me." Amen. 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 Maybe you're here today and maybe you raised your hand or maybe you didn't. You want to slip out of that pew or that seat and come down this altar and say, "Lord, here am I. Here am I." Listen, I know what the devil's telling some of you right now. Just stay right there. Somebody will think something about you. Listen, it ain't about what people think. People's here on this altar already praying for you. They're already up here praying for somebody that needs help. They're praying for themselves. They're getting the help that they need. Don't leave here today falling stuck in the crack. Get up here on this altar today and give it to God. Give it to Him. He loves you. He loves you so much. He loves you. Maybe you're here today, maybe you just want to get out of that seat, come to this altar, and thank God for being so good. Thank Him for being so good to you. Over time and over the years, oh, what God has done for us. Where He's brought us from, what He's brought us through. Would you come? Maybe you're here today, you've got a burden on your heart. Something you're going through, something your family member's going through. And you'd like for us to help you pray. Would you just slip your hand up, put it right back down, say, "Pray for me." Amen, amen. Y'all see his hands going up all over the house today. Amen, amen. We're praying for you. The Bible said for us to bear one another's burdens. They also said for you to cast your care upon Him because He cares for you. She's going to finish up playing with this verse, and this is going to be the last opportunity we ever have to come to talk to Jesus. Can you leave here today saying, "I'm satisfied, I'm full, I'm right where Jesus would have me"? If not, would you just give it to Him? Just give it to God. He loves you so much. You said you keep saying that, preacher, and I'm going to keep saying it until the day I die. God loves you. Brother Eddie, pray for us.
God, as we come before Thee, Father, we thank You for this day. Thank You for another opportunity to come together, God. And Lord, for Your word that we've heard today, the fellowship, the singing, every bit of it, God. I pray You'll bless each one that stand this way. There's not a lot of hands today, Lord, where they need to be. God, You know what they need. Lord, I pray You'll just help them, strengthen them, God, encourage them. Let them know that You do love them, God, and You're ready to forgive, Lord, whatever it is. And God, I thank You, Lord, for this place and this people. And God, I pray that You'll just help us, God, through this word, Lord, help us not to let our loved ones fall through the crowd. Any lost person, God, to let them know about Jesus, as we heard, God, how You love them, and Jesus died for them, Father. Pray as these You convict hearts, God, that people will repent and turn to Jesus before it's too late. Help them to realize, God, open their blinded eyes, and help them, God, to realize that time's running out, and God, they need to do something quick before the door's shut. And Lord, I just pray, God, again, You'll help us in our everyday life.
Yeah.
To be what we should be. God, be a light. Let Him shine till they can see Him in us, God. Look past us and see Jesus and the life that we live, God, for You. Lord, we can do nothing of ourselves. We're dependent upon You, God. And I'm thankful we serve the One that we can depend on. And Lord, I pray again for all that's on that prayer list and all that's not. Some that's not, don't feel like they should come, God. I pray You'll bless them and help them, God. Strengthen them, Lord. And thank You again for allowing us to come together to worship and praise our God and uplift Jesus. We give you glory and a praise for it all. In Jesus' name we pray, and that's these things. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We do appreciate you today. Maybe somebody's got a word or a testimony on your heart. Hearts and minds clear. We'll all stand to our feet. Do be much in prayer for service this afternoon. Sometime in the next few weeks, we're going to schedule a work day here at the church. We've got some things up down. We've been doing a little clearing up down the road. And we'll try to get this rolled up door put in this building out here. So you let me know what Saturday you're on.
2025.
Amen. Do be much in prayer for all on the prayer list. Tell somebody you love them. God bless you. See you this evening.